Hi, my name is Antony, and I'm an engineer working on Google Chrome extensions. I'm going to talk to you about a few topics related to the IDs, packaging, and distribution of extensions in our system. If you choose to use the Extensions Gallery to host and update your extensions, we take care of many of these details for you. If you plan to do the hosting and updates yourself, or if you're just curious, it can be helpful to know more about these concepts. If you've tried making a test extension, you've probably noticed that extensions have a strange-looking ID made up of 32 characters. When we designed the system, we wanted to have a single, globally unique identifier for each extension so that there are no conflicts with other extensions. What we didn't want, though, was to require any central authority to assign these unique IDs. The mechanism we settled on uses one public-private key pair per extension, with the hash of the public key determining the extension's ID. Because of the way public keys are randomly generated, the chance of a collision is extremely small. If you host your extension on the gallery, we create and store the private keys for you. And when you want to release a new version of your extension, all you need to do is log in, upload the new source files, and hit the publish button. Now I'll explore how the packaging and signature process works. Google Chrome extensions are packaged into CRX files. If you're using the gallery, we generate the CRX file for you when you hit the publish button. If you want to host your extension on your own site, you'll create the CRX file with the Pack Extension button on the Extensions Management page in Google Chrome. A CRX file is really just a zip file of your extension directory plus two more things: the public key and a signature of the zip contents made using the private key. When installing a CRX, Google Chrome extracts the public key, signature, and zipped content, and makes sure the signature is valid using the public key. What this means is that once users have installed a particular extension, they can get updates to it and be sure that the new versions were signed by the same private key as the original version. As with other types of software, developers often want to update extensions to fix security problems, bugs, and make general improvements. Google Chrome has a philosophy that client software should be a lot like web apps, where you always use the latest version and don't have to do any work to get updates. In the design of our extension system, we're following the same idea. So, we made auto-update available to all extensions, whether they're hosted in the gallery or not. The way auto-update works is pretty simple. An extension specifies an auto-update URL in its manifest, and the browser will check that URL every few hours for an XML file, which lists the most recent version of the extension and where to download it. The browser can fetch updated CRX files over a plain, non-SSL connection because it will check the signature inside the CRX file before installing it. If you're hosting your extension in our gallery, you don't need to worry about auto-update. We take care of it for you. If you're hosting your extensions yourself, you just need to include an auto-update URL in your extension's manifest.json file. I wanted to close this video by emphasizing a few important points for developers. First, a CRX file is really just a zip file with a little extra data tacked on. Second, each extension has a public-private key pair, so if you develop three different extensions, you'll have three separate key pairs. And finally, protecting the private key file is very important if you're self-hosting your extensions. To learn more, you can ask a question on our discussion group or check out our documentation on the web at code.google.com/chrome/extensions.